Hey, Jesse here from the Perot, hanging out in our life hall pondering the great diversity of organisms on our planet Earth. Where is everyone? I love exploring new environments and the animals adapted to live in them, especially in our great state. Is that really what I look like? I guess it's pretty close. Does life as we know it work beyond Earth? This is a question a scientist called an astrobiologist might try to answer. Astrobiology is the study of the origin, evolution, and distribution of life in the universe. Life as we know it on Earth needs three things: liquid water, the elements to build life, like carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, and sulfur, and the energy to sustain life. Some life on our planet can survive in environments once thought uninhabitable. We call these organisms extremophiles. Check out this sample of water I collected. It contains my favorite extremophile, tardigrades. Also called water bears, these organisms can enter what's called a ton stage and survive temperatures between 300 and negative 458 degrees Fahrenheit. They can also survive being exposed to the radiation and vacuum of space. Let's move to a hot spring in Yellowstone National Park. This algae, along with other bacteria, can thrive in this extremely acidic and hot environment. Now let's head to a hydrothermal vent, which is an opening in the seafloor out of which heated mineral-rich water flows. Not having access to the sun means microbes like this bacteria have to convert chemicals from the vents into usable energy. This is a process called chemosynthesis. These microbes make it possible for other organisms to thrive at these vents, like tube worms, crabs, and mussels. If we can find life in these harsh environments on Earth, is it so crazy to imagine life out of this world? Luckily, scientists have the tools and technology to explore this question. Let's learn more about the places beyond Earth that scientists think could possibly sustain life. Some educators from the museum have designed creatures with the adaptations needed to potentially live on other planets and even moons. Let's check them out.
I'm Jessica, here with my creature from Venus.
Venus is the second planet from the sun. The surface is about 870 degrees Fahrenheit and hot enough to melt lead. Its atmosphere consists mainly of carbon dioxide with clouds of sulfuric acid. There is speculation about life existing in the past, as well as potential for life in the top cloud layers of the atmosphere, where temperatures are less extreme.
This is Mike the microbe, who lives in the sulfuric acid clouds above Venus. Mike has super stable proteins that can function in his hot and acidic environment. These proteins help him create energy from the chemicals found in Venus's atmosphere.
Hello, this is Tim, and I've imagined a worm that might burrow through the soils on the planet Mars.
Mars is a rocky and dry planet. Iron minerals in the soil oxidize or rust, causing it to look red. Mars's surface cannot support life as we know it, but scientists are trying to determine the potential for future and past life.
My Martian worm has leathery skin to help prevent desiccation in the dry desert environments on Mars. It also appears to use the tubercles on its back to help it acquire moisture and oxygen in the thin atmosphere. Its name is Quado.
Catherine here. My creature is named Titanii, from Titan.
Titan is Saturn's largest moon and actually experiences weather similar to Earth. But instead of water, the compound methane causes clouds, rain, and snow. Titan's surface includes large ice caps, rivers, lakes, and deep oceans of liquid methane and ethane, which might be habitable to life very different from life on Earth.
Titan is covered mostly by ice, but deep underneath are liquid oceans made up of the compound methane. My creature could be a microorganism living in these deep oceans with an adaptation of a very strong outer cell wall. This would allow my creature to thrive at the high pressure and very cold temperatures found deep at these depths.
Oh, hello there. I'm Kristen, and this is my friend Barry from Enceladus.
Saturn's moon Enceladus has a cold and icy surface with a liquid salty water ocean beneath. Scientists have studied plumes of liquid water shooting into the atmosphere from warm cracks in the crust. These samples contain the chemical ingredients needed for life, like hydrogen. The seafloor likely contains hydrothermal vents releasing hot, mineral-rich water into its ocean.
Barry, the insulating octopod, lives near the South Pole region of Enceladus, where the hydrothermal vents keep the water nice and warm. He has a hard outer shell to protect his internal organs from the pressure of the water and ice above him, independent eyes on stalks so he can see all around him, and of course, eight legs so he can wander the seafloor.
Try creating a creature at home and share it with us at hashtag Perot Museum and hashtag Amaze Your Brain at Home. Thanks for joining us, and keep exploring!